Hello and welcome to Venice. This is Walks of Italy with Travel and Leisure, bringing you across the globe to experience the best walking tours of the planet. I'm Mosè and this is the Venice in a Day tour by Walks of Italy. You know, in this tour we have tried to really pack everything we could about Venice in a single day. Starting from here, where we are now, from the Rialto area, and then we visit the big monuments of the St. Mark's Square, the St. Mark's Basilica, and the Doge's Palace. Join us for this wonderful tour. In Campo San Giacometto, where we are right now, there is this interesting statue. It's called the Hunchback of Rialto. Okay, he's not really a hunchback actually, he's only leaning forward to keep the staircase behind him. This staircase was used to reach the top of this column. This column was used at the time of the Republic of Venice as the place for the herald. The herald stood there to give the news to the citizens. Look at the buildings around us. This, at the time of the Republic of Venice, was the trading center of the city. Okay, so you have to imagine under these porticos, trading posts, offices, banks, okay? You know, the whole economy of the Republic of Venice went around trade. This was a city of merchants. So the Rialto area really was one of the most important parts of the city.
In just a few steps, you can reach the famous Grand Canal.
The Grand Canal was in the past, and is still today, the main road, we could say, of Venice. But you know, in the past, these were actually all private homes, each one belonging to a single powerful noble family. You know, in the past, Venice was a republic. Okay, that's the reason why we call the old independent Venice the Republic of Venice. But it's important to underline it was an aristocratic republic. Only the nobles could vote and be elected. Okay, but you know, if you think that in the old times the other countries in Europe were all monarchies, okay, this was actually a pretty advanced political system for the times. The Rialto Bridge is one of the most famous bridges of the city. The reason is that for centuries it was the only bridge crossing the Grand Canal. So it was designed by the official architect working for the Republic of Venice in that moment. He was called Antonio da Ponte, and he had a very clever idea. He was able to arrange on the bridge two rows of shops. And still today, those are active shops. This is Campo Santi Giovanni e Paolo, one of the most beautiful monumental areas of Venice. We are close to the northern part of the city. You know, campo is the Venetian word for square, okay? And usually each campo takes the name from the name of the church next to it. And here behind me you can see the big church of St. John and St. Paul, Santi Giovanni e Paolo. Probably one of the most interesting things of this church is that it is clearly unfinished, especially the facade, okay? Probably they never had enough money to complete the original design. Notice that next to the church there is this magnificent building. This is the Scuola Grande di San Marco, the big school of St. Mark. Okay, you know, the schools in the Republic of Venice weren't really schools as we mean today. They were more like associations of citizens, we could say guilds. The members of these associations kept making donations to them. So these guilds were incredibly powerful, and when today we look at their main offices, we could say, we can really see their power. And by the way, this is nowadays the hospital of Venice, the public hospital of the city. So if you see people going in and out of that door, they're going to the hospital or they're coming from the hospital. And you know, in Venice, the ambulance is a boat.
Let's have a gondola ride together.
So here we are on this beautiful gondola. And nowadays, to explore this city, usually we walk, okay? But you know, something not a lot of people know is that there weren't a lot of streets in the old city, okay? Venice lies on a lot of small islands that originally were all disconnected, okay? So on foot in the past, you couldn't go very far. Everyone living here had a boat, and the boat was the main way to go around. So a lot of buildings in this city were built to be seen from the water. You know, another interesting thing about these boats is that even if today we use them in a very different way than we did in the past, we still build them as we did in the past, okay? Still today, the gondolas are all handmade, okay? So imagine what a unique piece of art you have around you every time you take a gondola ride.
After the gondola ride, finally reach the incredible St. Mark's Square.
The St. Mark's Basilica is probably the most important monument we have in Venice. It's really an incredible building, the result of centuries of work. Now this magnificent church is the Cathedral of Venice, so still today it's an active church, the most important religious building of the city. But you know, the interesting thing is that this only became the cathedral quite recently, actually, in the contemporary times. It wasn't originally built to be the cathedral. In the old times, this was the church of the state of the Republic of Venice, of the old independent city-state, okay? So we could say that in the past, this was more a political building than a religious building. I would say that probably the mosaics are the most beautiful work of art that we find inside this church. Okay, so let's go a little bit closer to look at the details of some of these beautiful mosaics. The story of the creation of this monument is really interesting. It was built as a sort of a lavish, precious tomb for St. Mark. The evangelist St. Mark is buried inside this church. You know, apart from the mosaics, the St. Mark's Basilica is also very famous for the precious marbles decorating this magnificent building. Look at these beautiful columns here. And have you noticed that they're all made with different kind of marbles? The reason is that most of this marble is actually recycled, taken from other monuments. It was quite common in the past. The bell tower of the St. Mark's Basilica is the highest building of Venice, 96 meters. An interesting thing though is that the bell tower is the only building in the square which is not original. The original bell tower completely collapsed, unfortunately, in 1902 and had to be rebuilt. But you know, the Venetians decided to rebuild it exactly as it was and where it was. From the terrace of the St. Mark's Basilica, there is a wonderful view, not just of the square, but also of the lagoon. Look, here we have on the left the magnificent Doge's Palace. On the other side, over there, in front of the Doge's Palace, we have the Marciana Library, the Library of St. Mark, the most important library we have in the city. It's a beautiful building of the Renaissance. From here, you also have a magnificent view of the two columns of the square. Look, the column on the left has the winged lion symbol of St. Mark, while the column on the right has the statue of St. Theodore killing the dragon. You know, Theodore was the very first patron saint of the Republic of Venice. Before the Venetians gathered the relics of St. Mark, the patron saint of this city was Theodore. All the buildings surrounding the square in front of the St. Mark's Basilica are called the Procuratie. These in the past were the offices of the Procuratori di San Marco, a very important political power at the time of the Republic of Venice. Doge's Palace, this big building behind me, was the most important political building at the time of the Republic of Venice. We could say it was the White House of the Venetians, the home of the Doge, but it was at the same time also the town hall, the House of the Parliament. All the politicians of the Republic of Venice worked here in the past. Notice the strong Eastern flavor, no, of this architectural language. You know, nowadays the Doge's Palace is a big museum, probably the most important museum we have in Venice. And when you enter this building nowadays, you can walk through these precious chambers where the politicians gathered in the past to debate and to vote. And you know, these chambers are incredibly well preserved, and they're decorated with some of the most beautiful paintings created by the artists of the Renaissance. When you visit the Doge's Palace nowadays, you can also enter the prison building. And that over there is the famous Bridge of Sighs, connecting the Doge's Palace with the prisons, okay? You know, this bridge has this weird name, by the way. This name was created in the Romantic age. Eh? You know, we started to call it Bridge of Size because basically the idea was that you had your trial in the Doge's Palace and then you were moved to your cell through the bridge. So the two small windows that you see over there on the bridge were basically the last chance for a lot of prisoners to see the outside world. So these size are supposed to be the size of the prisoners, okay? Saying goodbye to the world before being thrown in a dark cell for the rest of their days.
Se vieni qua giù, vedrai che paradiso.
And this was the Walks of Italy Venice in a Day tour. We did a lot of things together today. We were able to explore the Rialto area. We had a glimpse of Campo Santi Giovanni e Paolo, one of the most beautiful monumental squares of the city. We took a gondola ride. We finally reached the St. Mark's Square. And we have visited the magnificent monuments of the square. But you know, Walks of Italy offers many other tours here in Venice. We are waiting for you here so that you can discover with us this incredible city in person. Bye bye.